it's just a matter now of flipping it out of its bowl, dressing it with melted dark chocolate, fresh berries, and the leftover panettone is reborn as a beautiful new dessert.
There is nothing more traditional than panettone at Christmas time in an Italian family. And if, like me, you grew up in an Italian household, you know that weeks after Christmas, there is still panettone lying around in the cupboard. I think it's about time we turn this into something else. My mum makes this dessert called zuccotto, which is basically a panettone shell, and the inside is this beautiful creamy ricotta filling that almost tastes like cannoli. So you get panettone and cannoli in the one dessert. It is the bomb. And traditionally, I do make it with my mum when we have leftover panettone. But mum's in Italy, I'm here, so I'm gonna attempt to cook this recipe with mum remotely with the help of some technology. Ah! Ciao! Non ti ho svegliato? Allora, mamma, I'm gonna show you this ricotta because it's really nice.
Mum's recipe always starts with some full cream ricotta mixed nicely in a bowl. Then add 4 tablespoons of icing sugar.
This is not a very sweet, creamy mixture.
Non è necessario che lo zuccotto sia troppo dolce perché il panettone è già sweet enough.
I'm gonna show you. It's nice and fluffy. Can you see?
Okay.
All right.
Okay,
okay, so that's the first thing done. I mean, I could stick my finger in it and just have a try because it's so good, but I won't.
You need to.
Really?
Just put your finger in.
Really? Oh, mum's saying that I have to, so. Sembra il cannolo. It tastes like cannoli. It's so good. Okay, now I'm gonna whip some cream and I'm just gonna pop it in here so that it's gonna be easier.
The idea is to whip the cream until it has soft peaks and then fold it gently into the ricotta mixture.
Okay, mamma, guarda. This is super creamy now and lump-free as well. Okay, so what I'm gonna do is, because we're gonna create 2 different mixtures. One is sort of vanilla flavored and one is chocolate flavored. So I'm gonna divide this up into 2 and pop some back in here.
That's good. You are doing well, brava ragazza.
Thank you. Okay, let's start with the vanilla cream. Okay, in this one, if you can get a real ingredient like a real vanilla pod to go.
It makes a difference. It makes a difference.
It does make a difference. Mum's right.
Yeah.
And whatever mum says goes.
To create your vanilla filling, blend the vanilla seeds with some chocolate chips to your first bowl and mix through. And to make the zuccotto's chocolate filling, start by adding some cocoa powder to your second bowl.
I'm gonna add some cinnamon as well. Is that a good idea?
Okay. Sì, bello.
Like
buono.
1 teaspoon like and it. A half, yeah. Maybe, and mix it through. And do I add a little bit of marsala to this mixture as well?
I always do. A drop of marsala, yeah.
Which is an Italian sweet wine. A couple of drops in this mixture.
Yeah,
elevates it. Not too
it
much.
Flavor.
And look, if you're making this for children, don't use marsala, just use... You could use some orange juice, actually, to further the idea of the orange.
Even, you know, some drops of coffee, maybe.
Ooh, that would be nice. Yeah. Like espresso.
Espresso, yeah.
And to finish off, the zest of half an orange.
So now it's basically just an assembly job. And so we're gonna cut our panettone into slices so that we can line a bowl that I have lined with some cling wrap so that it's gonna make this job a lot easier.
Now, carefully cut a 2 centimeter slice from the base of the panettone, which we will be needing later. Then cut the rest of the panettone into 1 centimeter slices.
This is what I'm doing. I'm cutting 2 semicircles from a slice. And then I'm gonna pour some marsala in here. Very lightly dipping the panettone slices in and out because I don't want it to be too soggy. But look, this is basically...
This is real cooking. This is how we do it. So,
it is. And now I'm gonna line the base of my bowl, just like that. Mamma, ti faccio vedere.
Next, line the sides of the bowl with the soaked panettone slices and start with the vanilla filling.
Three layers.
Then the chocolate filling and finish again with vanilla.
Bellissima.
Ok, adesso però devo fare il coperchio.
Using the 2 cm base of panettone we put aside, cut off the crust, soak it in marsala, and cap the zuccotto layers. Then wrap it and use a heavy weight to compress it.
And because this rests in the fridge overnight with this weight on top, by the time you ease it out onto a platter, it will look beautiful and it will be super firm inside.
Yeah.
Okay, mamma, grazie mamma. Ciao, ciao. It's time to unveil it and remove the weights that have kept it in place overnight.
It's just a matter now of flipping it out of its bowl, dressing it with melted dark chocolate, fresh berries, and the leftover panettone is reborn as a beautiful new dessert.
Time to cut and reveal its inner beauty. Oh, yes! Look at that! That is so good! Oh my goodness. Few berries, of course, and I'm gonna have to cut a few more slices because I've got eager friends awaiting. Oh, look at that. This is going to taste so good. You have the soft ricotta interior, but the melted chocolate has set almost hard, so the contrast is going to be so amazing. A few spoons. È pronto! Hey, that was